my name is Danny Nichols. I am a first-year student at Columbia College. I'm working on a Bachelor of Science degree in Business Administration. And part of this speech class is a requirement for me to complete my program. Even though this is a requirement, one of the things that I really would like to get out of this class is a little bit more formal training in public speaking. I know I have some strengths and some weaknesses and some things I can improve upon, and I'm going to talk about what my strengths are first. And I think my first strength as a public speaker is being able to speak in a manner that keeps the information informative. There's nothing more worse than sitting and listening to a speech and somebody rambles on about things that have absolutely nothing to do with the speech. I'm able to put together a presentation or a speech that keeps the information in a manner that keeps the audience interested in. I think my second strength as a public speaker is using visual aids. I spend 100 times more on actually creating the presentation than I do with giving the speech. I pride myself very much on using PowerPoint. I make sure that all my colors, all my fonts, all my pictures, everything is perfect. I think people judge you on how well your presentation is made. If your presentation is sloppy or has too much information, it kills your presentation. And even though I know I have some strengths as a public speaker, I also know that I have some weaknesses. My first weakness is being so nervous that you use filler words. Filler words are words like and, I probably have already used it in this speech already. The reason we use filler words is that our mind is thinking so far ahead on giving a speech, we're thinking more of what we want to say than what we're actually saying. So we throw in these filler words until our minds can catch back up. My second weakness as a public speaker is working myself so much up on making sure that the speech is going to be good or the presentation is going to be good, I'll make myself sick, where I feel lightheaded, I'll be so nervous, I'll sweat, and this is very much a weakness. And what's interesting is a lot of times I feel like I'm going to pass out, I do my presentation, and someone will say, wow, you didn't look nervous at all. And even though I've recognized that I have some strengths and some weaknesses, I know that there's areas that I can improve upon. The first area that I can improve upon is using more of a systematic approach to doing a presentation or a speech. I always present in a manner that I think people want to hear, or at least how I would like to hear it. And it comes off good, but I would like to think more about the introduction of my speech, the body of my speech, and then the conclusion of my speech. I also know that I need to work on an area of improvement on giving formal toasts. At our company, we'll get together for a large event with distributors or customers or end users, and you'll be asked to give a toast at the last minute. I would rather that we had a little bit of notice so that we could prepare for that toast. Regardless of that, I'm going to start preparing ahead of time on doing an unbelievable toast at a company event. I would rather prepare for that toast and not give it than to show and be unprepared. So in conclusion, as a speaker, I will have to continue to give speeches throughout the rest of my career. I've been doing speeches and presentations for about 15 years. I've seen myself grow as a public speaker, and I remember a time that I had to do my first speech in front of 150 people. It was in Chicago, Illinois, and I got hung on a filler word, and that filler word was actually. I used the word actually 57 times in a 30-minute speech. I'm not nervous, it's very hot in this room, but I remember feeling that I failed at giving that speech. And I remember the vice president of that company walking up to me, and who's the president of our company now, saying, you did a great job. Thank you, and have a great day.